10 years since I did one of these. Dasa said she lost my original one, though. Bummer. My name is Colonel, so... Hey. Hi. Let's see. Bombs fell when I was a kid. My dad died in the war, you know, so... This is all pretty normal. My story is, I guess... boring. So Dasa found me when I was 13 or so. She brought me the responders. They taught me everything. I became a volunteer. It was great. For the past 5 years, I've been a responder myself. I help kids who lost their families. Get them safe. Trained. Just act like a big brother. Every year we find fewer people, though, so... I don't know. Things are not good out there. Just getting simple food and water is tough. And the Brotherhood. Well, we thought that would be different. We thought everything would be different, though. Well, so anyway, maybe in 10 years, Dasa will ask me to do another one of these survivor stories. Till then, peace, Appalachia.
That overseer lady said more people would be coming. It's nice to meet you.
Overseer's Law, town of Flatwoods. My God. There's no one here. The old tavern, the church, people were using them for shelter, but they're gone. Mutations, we expected. But there's something else. A disease. I was attacked by... Well, it used to be a person. But it had these green, glowing lesions, and its voice... angry, tortured.
That overseer lady said more people would be coming. It's nice to meet you.
Before they were wiped out, the survivors called themselves the responders. Looks like they were made of firefighters, police, emergency medical staff.
Hey,
they even have an automated system to teach people about
supplies,
water,
bombs, got
survival.
You covered.
I'm doing their tests, and you should too. I know it's even worse than we imagined, but... someone's got to know where the missile silos are, and how to...
With smarts and a little luck, you'll do just fine out there.
South of Vault 76. I knew this wasn't going to be the Appalachia I remembered, but... mutated animals? Haywire bots? No people so far. We have to be ready to rebuild in... what I can confirm is... hostile territory. Fortunately, Vault Tech was prepared. You see this? Cooking station, the stash box, the workbenches, all built with the camp. You need a home base out there. The construction and assembly mobile platform is designed to give you one. Just add resources, planning, and a little elbow grease. When you move your camp, everything you've built is stored, ready to be placed back down in the new area. Use this to establish a foothold whenever you're in unfamiliar territory. I've left my camp behind so you can use it. I know I'm breaking my own advice by not taking it with me. But after seeing Appalachia for myself, I need to make sure every resident of 76 has a safe haven they can start from. I'll make do without it. If it's still standing, the town of Flatwoods is further down this road. Find me there. This is the Overseer, signing off.
Surviving kids from the high school whose parents didn't make it. You for a while. After a bit, I was able to solder the circuitry in an old radio, and we tuned in to a broadcast from the responders. Oh, we were overjoyed. The trip from Watoka to Flatwoods, it was rough, mind you. The kids and I ran into a group of assholes in the mountains who stole our food and water. I can't tell you how happy I was to find the survivors in Flatwoods. Tents for everyone, open kitchen, medical supplies, protection. We were safe. They had a problem, though. Their water sources were contaminated heavily. People were boiling water, but not long enough to make it safe. So, I stepped up and I said, I'll build a testing kit to monitor the contamination, and I will teach folks how to properly boil water. And I did. The world is getting better, but slowly. We need to make sure it doesn't relapse, too. It's going to take time and care, that's all. Well, time, care, and science.
Continuing composting operations. Detecting potential composting target. Scanning for fertilizer.
Overseers. Let's call these personal journals. Not an official log, just something for me. The Agricultural Center, one of my first posts with Vault-Tec. I was so excited because I used to come to this same farm when I was a kid. I remember one year at the Autumn Festival, me running through the corn maze, going every which way, Mom and Dad yelling after me to slow down. Wasn't gonna happen. I guess I was always hitting my fast. Couldn't just be a pioneer scout. I had to make troop leader. Couldn't just be a good student. I had to have straight A's. God, I miss those early days. Being a kid, the three of us, our simple life, our simple house. I wonder if it's still standing. Overseer's log, town of Flatwoods. My God, there's no one here. The old tavern, the church, people were using them for shelter, but they're gone. Mutations we expected. But there's something else, a disease. I was attacked by, well, it used to be a person. But it had these green, glowing lesions, and its voice, angry, tortured. We are one. One what? Whatever happened here is beyond anything we expected. And we expected a lot. Before they were wiped out, police, emergency medical staff. They even have an automated system to teach people about treating water, food, survival. I'm doing their tests, and you should too. I know it's even worse than we imagined, but someone's got to know where the missile silos are and how to secure them. The responders are the best lead we have. This is the Overseer, signing off.
Begin mulching subroutines. Detecting potential composting targets. Thank you.
Overseer's log, or should I say, direct communication. Because whoever is listening to this had the moxie to try to find out where I've gone. But I'm glad you did. Truth is, I need your help. I've been given a task, and I've decided to break protocol and tell you what it is. Because if there's one thing I...
Responder Dasa gave me some supplies in exchange for one of survivors. Scott Shepard. Things are going all right. I was a nurse before the war. I guess nothing much has changed. I just work for the responders now. I don't get paid. The government is basically the same now as it was years ago. Wrecked. Disorganized. Cannot be trusted. Everyone knows this. You want to know why the war actually happened? Aliens. Think I'm joking? Listen, right before everything went to hell, I saw him. I was grilling hamburgers out in the yard with my dog, and I heard rustling from the bushes and a zapping noise. Next thing I know, I'm lightheaded and I felt myself falling to the ground. And I didn't even have a lot to drink. I woke up and I saw some little thing run into the bushes with my dog following it. And I knew. I found my dog later with a clump of green skin in his mouth. Green! Like moss or something. The bombs fell almost 10 days later. 9 days, 19 hours to be exact. That's 235 hours precisely. You know it is, right? That's right. The atomic number of the fissile isotope of uranium. They had a plan from the very beginning. Why would they come after me first? Scott Shepard, the nurse. Well, good question. I'm glad you asked. They have our blood. They knew which ones of us would survive. This is one big experiment to them. This whole thing was staged. Our lives, our thoughts, everything was designed for us, just like this conversation. Every word I'm saying. Planned. Time to wake up, Appalachia. Find the ones holding the strings and cut the cords.
Thank you. Delbert Winters here, born and raised in this very town. Lent my own church to the responders for their outpost here, and you're welcome. The responders are on a true mission, you see, helping folks through thick and thin, till the heavens open up again and take us all up anyways. When this all happened, I figured like most, it was time. This was the end, but it wasn't, was it? We're still here. At first, I thought it was a mistake, that we was missed, forgotten. Maybe we did some wrongs. Didn't give enough to charity, maybe. Didn't praise his name, even in the worst of times. Maybe thought some things that ought not to have been thought. So I asked him. I asked how? Why? I fought your wars on Earth. My despair, I saw some survivors eating raw rat carcass behind a dumpster. You ought to cook that first, I warned them. Seemed obvious. We tried but got sick, they said, covered in their own filth. I realized right then and there that I was being tasked. From then on, I built kitchens, cooked good food, fed anyone who walked up with an empty belly, and I was thankful for my task in life. Thankful. Next time hell or high water land in my stoop, I'll be swept clear away with it. But till then, let's share a home-cooked meal together, all right?
need some ammo, chems, or spiky bits to stab people with, you may find some here. Now in stock. Goods acquired through questionable means. Vendor not responsible for your safety or the safety of goods purchased. Please don't stab other customers while they shop. This vendor unit is equipped with anti-theft measures. Don't get any ideas, chump. You looking at me? How about you stop looking and start buying?
Commit no murder. Ooh, McNeil, don't steal my wheel.